This evening, the reading is taken from St. Mark Gospel, chapter 1, verses 35 to 39. 今晚上的经文是记载在马可福音第一章35节到39节。Mark chapter 1, verse 35. Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went off to a solitary place where he prayed. Simon and his companions went to look for him, and when they found him, they exclaimed, "Everyone is looking for you." Jesus replied, "Let's go to somewhere else. To the nearby villages, so I can preach there also. This is what I have come." So he traveled throughout Galilee, preaching in their synagogues and driving out demons. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ.
弟兄姐妹，大家晚上好。
Before we begin, let us pray.
在我们还没开始之前，让我们一起祷告。
Father Lord, we give thanks that we are here to learn your word.
父神，我们感谢你，我们再次来到这里来学习你的话语。
Speak to us, Lord.
请你对我们说话。Speak
to us. May Holy Spirit work mightily, greatly, at the same time, tenderly. In our hearts.
请你对我们说话, 愿你的圣灵大能在我们心里面动工。
In Jesus' name we pray.
这样祷告是奉主耶稣基督的名字求。
Amen.
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 We are in this new sermon series, Just Like Jesus, and today we are going to learn how to have a listening heart like Jesus.
我们进入了像耶稣一样的这个新的正道系列。那今天我们要学习要如何效法耶稣，能够有一颗倾听的心。And
to have a listening heart, we must learn from Jesus, and not only from him, but to experience him.
那要有一颗倾听的心呢，我们要向耶稣学习，而不只是从他学习，我们要经历神。Now,
experience Jesus in our life is truly personal journey and our responsibility that we can't let others do for us.
经历耶稣在我们的生命里面呢，是一个很个人的经历，并不是我们可以请别人来代替我们完成的一件事情。The
same way we can't let others eat for us, but we must feed ourselves.
就如我们没有办法让别人代替我们吃饭，我们需要自己进食。Now,
an example, we all love vacations, isn't it?
比如说，我们都很喜欢去旅行，对吧？
How many of you miss to travel?
有多少个人很想念去旅行呢？假假了，没有举手。Those who didn't raise your hands, you're talking
I love traveling.
我也很喜欢去旅行。And
even though, as we travel, not need to prepare a lot of things, and it could be very hassle.
那即便我们知道，就是旅行呢是一个很繁琐的事情，我们要准备很多的事情。But
we never send someone on vacation for us.
但是我们从来不会请别人代替我们去旅行，对吧？
Imagine if you send someone on vacation for us, and when he returns, we hear all about it, so that we don't have to experience or hassle things.
你可以想象一下，就是当我们请别人去代替我们旅行，那他回来再告诉我们说，哦，我经历了什么事情，那我们从他那里听，然后不需要经历这些很繁琐的事。
Would you do that?
你会这样吗？
No, isn't it?
不会，对吧？
Definitely no. We all want the experience in the first hand.
我们每个人都需要想要经历第一手的经验。We
want the sight first hand.
我们要就是第一手的可以看见那件事情。We
want to taste the food first hand.
我们要亲身的去尝食物的味道。We
want to enjoy.
我们要去享受。And
there are certain things in our life that no one can do for us, but only ourselves.
因此，其实我们生命中有许有一些事情是自己必须得自己去完成的，别人不无法替我们做的。It
is the same way in our spiritual growth and our relationship with Jesus.
同样的，在我们的属灵生命成长，还有我们跟神跟耶稣之间的经历，是没有人可以替代的。
You and I, need a first-hand encounter and experience with God, not through our pastor or our cell group leaders alone.
你和我都需要亲身的经历耶稣, 而不是透过我们的牧师传道或者是我们的小组组长帮助我们。
But ourselves with the help of the Holy Spirit.
而是我们亲身去经历, 透过圣灵的帮助。
So tonight, through Mark, the Gospel of Mark, and in chapter 1, verse 35 to 39, we see Jesus as a listening heart as he listens to the Holy Spirit.
所以今天晚上在马可福音一章35到39节, 我们看到耶稣他有一颗倾听的心。
Now, in Mark's writing, it shows us the pattern of the life and ministry of Jesus.
那在马可他在他的著作里面, 我们可以看到耶稣, 他展示了耶稣的侍奉还有他的生命。
In the whole chapter 1, Jesus had a tight schedule, right? He's traveling from one place to another and doing his ministry from morning till evening.
在整个的第一章,我们可以看到耶稣他有一个非常满的行程,从早上侍奉一直到傍晚。
He preached the word with authority and left the people astonished, okay? And he healed many, those who are sick.
他以权威的方式去传道,然后使许多的人感到惊奇,他医治了许多有病的人。
And not only this, Jesus cast out many demons and even commanded the demons not to speak. Because the demon knew who Jesus was. And Jesus has the authority when to reveal his identity to the people.
不仅如此, 耶稣还赶走了许多的鬼, 甚至命令这些鬼不能够说话, 因为鬼知道耶稣是谁。 耶稣有权利去决定任何时候要去跟任何的人去透露他的身份。
Surprisingly, such a tight schedule did not stop Jesus from having his time with the Father.
但是很令人惊奇的就是说, 即便是这么繁忙的一个行程, 并没有阻止耶稣亲自跟神之间的时间。
With all the tight schedule, Jesus could have take a longer rest. But instead, in verse 35, we see that early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus went out to a desolate place to pray.
耶稣本可以, 因着有很长的这个, 很密集的这个行程, 他可以有很长的休息时间, 但是在第35节中, 我们可以看到, 清晨, 当天天未亮的时候, 耶稣就去到旷野去祷告。
If we carry on to read the whole gospel, and then we can find out a few accounts that Jesus withdrew himself from the crowd and privately went to a solitary place to pray.
如果我们有继续去看其他的福音书, 我们可以看到就是说, 耶稣他很多次从人群中抽身出来, 然后私下到一个可以独处的地方祷告。
Before he feed the 5,000, he went to pray.
在他还没有喂饱5,000人之前, 他先去祷告。
Before he walks on the water, he prayed.
在他还未在水上面行走之前, 他祷告。
He spent time with the Father alone.
他花时间和天父相处, 独处。
And with the news of Jesus spread abroad, he withdrew himself, you know.
当耶稣这个关于耶稣的消息传遍天下的时候呢, 他还是找一个地方独处。
Why?
为什么呢?
Now, as we see all these references, we can see there's a pattern.
当我们在看这些被引用的经文的时候, 我们可以看到一个模式。
And especially in Luke chapter 5, verse 15 to 16, mentioning that Jesus often withdrew to a lonely places and prayed.
那特别是我们可以在路加福音5章15到16节看到，也提到耶稣经常退到可以独处的地方祷告。
Such a pattern is not only happening after Jesus started his ministry, but even before.
而这样的模式并不是只有在耶稣开始他的侍奉的时候这样，甚至在他还没有开始服事之前，他也是这样。
In the same passage in Mark chapter 1, okay, verse 9 to 13, after Jesus' baptism, we found that the Spirit drove Jesus into wilderness for 40 days and was tempted by Satan.
在同样的一章里面，就是马可福音第一章第9至13节，我们看到耶稣受洗之后呢，我们发现圣灵促使耶稣到旷野40天被撒旦试探。It
is the Spirit drove him.
是圣灵促使他去的。Jesus
listened to the Spirit.
而耶稣听从圣灵的感动。And
there he was with the wild animals, and the angels were ministering him.
在那里有许多的野兽，当然天使也在那里服侍他。
And from all the examples given, we can observe that Jesus was filled with the Spirit to do his ministry. In the same way, it is the Spirit who led Jesus to withdraw himself from the crowd to a desolate place to pray.
从所有刚刚我们举的例子中，我们可以看见，就是耶稣在他执行他的事工的时候，是被圣灵充满的。同样的是，圣灵引导耶稣从人群中抽身出来，然后到一个僻静的地方去祷告。Now,
a listening heart is a heart that listening to the Holy Spirit.
一颗倾听的心是聆听圣灵的心。Listening
to the Holy Spirit help us in imitating Christ and to live a life like Jesus.
聆听圣灵有助于帮助我们效法基督，像耶稣一样生活。Just
as how the Spirit led Jesus in his life, in his ministry, in fulfilling God's will.
就好像圣灵在耶稣的生命中如何，还有他的事工中如何引导他完成上帝的旨意。We
not only listen, but we need the Holy Spirit to move us.
我们不仅要聆听，我们还要让圣灵来感动我们。Especially
when we are too comfortable with our current lifestyle.
特别是当我们对于现在的现状非常的满意的时候，That
may not be pleasing to God.
这或许其实不是合神心意的。When
on-site service is not allowed, as we are worshiping at home, you know.
当我们没有办法来到实体崇拜的时候，我们在家里崇拜的时候，你知道的。Now,
asking help from the Holy Spirit is truly reliable and workable to all of us.
那就是当我们祈求圣灵来帮助我们的时候呢，是一个非常可靠而且是可行的方法。Because
Jesus himself proved it.
因为耶稣本身就证明了这一点。
Jesus once came in a human form. He was incarnated.
耶稣基督道成肉身来到我们当中。Jesus
experienced what we are experiencing now.
他经历了我们现在经历的一切。He
has felt what we are feeling now.
他感受我们现在所感受的。
And he struggled with what we are struggling now.
他甚至也体会过我们的挣扎。But
something very promising is that God did not leave us as an orphan.
但是让我们觉得很欣慰的是，耶稣并没有让我们好像孤儿一样没有无助。With
God's purpose and grace, he gave us Jesus to make us holy in his sight. So that the Holy Spirit able to remain in us as a helper, to teach us all the things, and a spirit that is not of fear, but of power, love, and self-control.
而是以他的目的还有恩典，将耶稣赐给我们，使我们在他眼中成为圣洁，以便圣灵能够藏在我们里面，给我们做保惠师，教导我们一切。
And with his own purpose and grace, he gave us Jesus.
以他的目的还有恩典，他给了我们耶稣。He
gave us the Holy Spirit.
他给了我们圣灵。There
are many of us busy with our studies, maybe students busy with tuitions, or for parents, or newly couple, okay, busy with works, with your own family, and getting less of me time.
我们当中有许多人繁忙于 课业、学业、补习，甚至有些刚结婚、新婚的伴侣，甚至为了家庭、工作平衡，都觉得非常的忙碌。Now,
in order to let your me time to be more beneficial and fruitful, it is to be with God.
因此，我们就少了许多独处的时间。那要让我们的这个独处时间更有益处的话，我们独处的时间应该就是跟神在一起的时间。And
just as how Jesus did.
这就是耶稣所做的。That
he withdrew himself to God. In the same way, we withdrew ourselves from our busyness, from our distraction to God.
这是与神一起，他抽身离开人群，然后跟神相处。同样的，我们要从我们的忙碌中抽身出来，跟神独处。If
you struggle to find a time or even a place, ask the help from the Holy Spirit to reveal it to you.
如果你苦于寻找一个时间，甚至一个地点来去做这件事情的话， 向上帝祷告，求圣灵来显示给您知道哪里可以去做这件事情。And
claim that time and the place, claim it for God.
而且要宣告那个时间、那个地点，就是给神的时间还有地点。During
this Lent season, as the church is mobilizing in cell group, to take part in this early morning prayer meeting, it's an opportunity, for you, for me, to be ministered by God through our prayer meeting.
那在这个大灾期间， 由教会所进行的这个所动员的这个细胞小组参加晨祷会这件事情呢，其实是一个很好的机会来帮助我和你都能够更加亲近神，被神服侍。
If you find it very difficult to wake up early morning in 6 a.m.Ask the Holy Spirit help you.
如果你觉得早上六点钟起床真的很困难，求圣灵帮助你。
Surely He will help.
圣灵肯定会帮助你的。
I'm not a morning person.
我不是早上清早就可以起床的人。
But He wake me up early in the morning.
但是每一天早上，就是圣灵会感动我，让我起床。
Even before the alarm.
甚至在我的铃声就是那个闹钟响之前，我就醒了。
If you find out that your passion, you have lost your passion.Ask the Holy Spirit to revive it.
如果你发现自己的热忱似乎你已经失去了这个热忱的话，求圣灵帮助你再找回这个热忱。
He can walk with you in your spiritual walk with Jesus.
他能够帮助你在你跟耶稣的这个属灵的成长当中能够更加的亲近。
So how long has it been, no, since you let God to have you?
那你这是。就是你多久没有让上帝拥有完整的你呢？
How long since you gave him a portion of undiluted, uninterrupted time and listened to his voice?
就是你有多久没有就是给他一段没有被其他东西分心或者是分掉你的注意力的一个时间呢？
Oh, Jesus did, no? He listens to the Holy Spirit and made a deliberate effort to spend time with God.And Jesus makes himself available for the Father.
显然耶稣他做到了，他刻意的花时间和神相处，因为耶稣为了天父腾空出自己的时间还有专注力。
Now in the following verse, it is interesting at how Mark describes Simon and the others followers looking for Jesus.
那在接下来的经文我们可以看到是很有趣的，就是西门他跟他其他的这些追随者怎么样去寻找耶稣。
The word that Mark used in the Greek text.
那马可在用这个经文的时候，这个字眼的时候，在希伯来文，
什么？希腊文。
希腊文说的是
katadiokein. Originally, it brings more hostile sense. You know, it expresses the eagerness or concern or even disgruntled.
那它原来的这个。读法呢，它这个字眼呢，它用的就是比较粗俗一点，就有点像是去猎捕，就是有点去追逐，比较粗俗的一些字眼。
Does not mean that they hate Jesus or they want to kill Jesus. No.
这不表示他们很恨耶稣，然后他们要杀掉耶稣，不是这样。
But have this sense of like disgruntled, not satisfied.
那就是有不满意、急切的这样子的想法。
And why would they have such a way? And I'm like, why they have such feeling?
为什么他们会有这样的感受呢？
Probably they couldn't understand Jesus why.
或许他们不能够理解耶稣做的这件事情，为什么他这么做？
And in the same chapter from verse 27 to 33, people were spreading about Jesus even without knowing who Jesus really is.
甚至在同一章的第27到33节呢，这些人在还没有完全认识耶稣的时候，就已经在传遍关于耶稣了。
They are questioning themselves.
他们或许对自己也有质疑。
But they came to Jesus.
但是他们仍然来到耶稣面前。
They came with their own motive and intention.
带着自己的目标、自己的动机。
Instead of like seeking who Jesus really was.
而不真的是寻求真正的耶稣这个人是谁。
No, every time they came, they bring a lot of their own agenda.They bring sick people, they bring those who are possessed by demon.
那每次他们来，他们都是带着自己的动机跟意图，他们带病人，那些被鬼附的人。
Though Jesus never refused them, no, but showing mercy and kindness by ministering their needs.
但耶稣从来没有就是拒绝他们，只是以他的恩典还有他的怜悯去来服侍这些人的需求。
Jesus healed them and cast all those demons.
那耶稣医治了他们，也把这些鬼都赶掉。
But here, as they ask, "Where are you, Jesus?"
可在这里，当他们询问耶稣你在哪里
？Everyone is looking for you.
大家都在找你。
And there are some other passages. The same way, you know, people are looking for Jesus with their own agendas.
甚至我们可以看到有一些其他的经文也有说到其他的人他们用自己的意图自己的目标去找耶稣。
And there are times when Jesus realized that the demands of the people does not in line with God's will, especially in John chapter 6. After Jesus fed the 5,000 people,
那有些时候耶稣意识到人们的要求甚至是不符合耶稣不符合上帝的旨意，特别是在约翰福音六章十四至十五节，耶稣喂饱了五千人之后呢？
The people saw the sign that Jesus had done, and they wanted to take Jesus by force to make him king.
人们看见耶稣的作为这个神迹，那他们想要迫使强迫耶稣成为他们的王。
But Jesus did not immerse himself to such shallow acceptance.
但是耶稣并没有沉浸于这些人对于他这些肤浅的期许。
He did not answer them by becoming a political king.
他并没有因此而成为他们的这个政治上面的王。
But he withdrew himself away from the crowd, but to be available for God, becoming a king for all nations.
而是把自己从人群中抽离出来，然后为上帝做所有人的王。
As Simon and his and the followers searching for Jesus,
当西门还有这些追随者在寻找耶稣的时候，
but with their own agenda,
但是是带着自己的意图的时候呢？
Looking at ourselves, many of us find comfortable the very first encounter with God, just like Peter. You know, wow, they are happy. You know, Jesus do a lot of miracles.
那我们借鉴这件事情，然后看回自己的时候，我们会发现，就是很多时候我们就好像他们一样，刚开始，有跟耶稣、跟神的经历的时候，我们觉得一切都好美好。
And because our first encounter is so sweet, we see healing, we see blessing.
因为我们看到有医治、有祝福，我们觉得一切都很甜美。
And we may come to God with our own agenda.
那我们就变得带着自己的意图来到神面前。
And God still accepted us.It is mercy and kindness.
即便如此，神仍然以他的恩典和怜悯来接纳我们。
But slowly, when we find ourselves comfortable and remain stagnant and not willing to move on in our relationship with Jesus,
但渐渐的，我们会发现自己就是在这个舒服区，我们不愿意去做出任何的改变，想要保持现状跟耶稣之间的关系。
And through our journey with God, we start to find out what it means that our holy God is.
在我们跟神之间的经历的时候，在经历神的这个过程中，我们终于理解到圣洁神是什么意思的时候。
How different that God works in our lives.
我们意识到神在我们生命里面所做的是何等的不一样的时候。
And it is always the opposite way, you know, from what we think.
很常这些的事情跟我们的想法是背道而驰的。
And we find it so uncomfortable sometimes.
甚至有时候我们会觉得非常的不舒服。
When we pray to God, why God, you're not answering us?
我们祷告的时候，我们说，神啊，为什么你没有垂听我们的祷告？
We find ourselves disgruntled like Simon.
我们就会发现自己就很像西门一样，非常的不满。
We get frustrated to God.
我们甚至对神发脾气，发怒。
Don't you know, God, I'm looking for you?
你难道不知道吗？上帝，我在找你。
Don't you know, God, I need your help right now?
你难道不知道我现在就需要你的帮助吗？神。
Don't you know, God, this is the best way to solve my problem?
你难道不知道这是最好能够解决我的问题的方法吗？
But to be truth, God knows our needs, but at the same time, He is sovereign in His decision for what He wants and how to reveal according to His will and purpose.
说实话，其实神知道我们的需要是什么，但他同时是完全有这个主权去决定他想要按什么样的形式，要按照他的旨意还有他的目的来去揭示他在这方面的主权。
We need to learn to move on from our first encounter with God.
我们需要学习从我们第一次经历神的这个经验，要从这里成长过去，就是
we cannot hold on to our own intention, our own motive, our agenda to demand God to answer according to our own ways.
我们必须继续往前走，我们不能够执意的坚持自己的意图和动机，然后要求神按照我们的方式去回答我们的问题。
We have to grow in our faith in God to learn to make ourselves available to God.
我们必须要在 对神的信心中成长。我们要学会向神求助，来谦卑自己，让上帝按照他的旨意来服侍。
And humble ourselves, allowing God to minister us according to His will and purpose, His way.
就是让神按照他的旨意、他的方法来去服侍我们。
Because God is sovereign in all things, including you and me, our lives.
因为上帝他有拥有完全的主权，包括他掌管你和我的生命。
Making ourselves available to be occupied by God and for God to rule us as king.
让我们被神占据我们的生命，来掌权我们的生命，做我们的王。
Let us learn from Jesus, you know, how he makes himself available not to people only, but to God.
让我们来向耶稣学习，好让他不就是耶稣他不只是让其他的人占据他的时间，但是他也抽出时间来跟神相处。
He has this listening heart, listen to the Holy Spirit.
他有一颗聆听的心，他听从圣灵。
To be available for God.
好让他能够为主所用。
This available is not only for to serve God full time.
这样的腾空自己呢，不只是全时间的服侍神。
But to be moved, to be shaped. By God,
而是给神来去陶造、塑造
through His own way,
透过神的方法
not my way,
不是我的方法
not your way,
不是你的方法
So, let us be available to our Heavenly Father, who knows us very well.
因此，让我们让非常了解我们的天父来占据我们的生命，掌管我们生命
As we come to church service or even cell group, it's not because we needed something alone only, but because We want to be with God, and we allowing God to minister us according to His will and purpose.
当我们来到教会甚至是小组的时候，我们并不是因为我们有东西要向神求，或者是有特别的意图，而是我们要来到这里来亲近神，来让神来服侍我们。我们也要去亲近他。
At the same time, we make ourselves available for our brothers and sisters to learn to minister one another, to support one another in the body of Christ.
同时我们也学会在基督的肢体里面我们要来彼此服侍我们的兄弟姐妹。
So how can we find ourselves a listening heart that is familiar with the Holy Spirit working in us and the sovereignty of our Heavenly Father?
那我们要如何才能够发现自己有一颗熟悉圣灵的工作和天父的主权的这样的一个倾听的心呢？
It is allowing the word of God to be preached to us.
是透过允准上帝的话语向我们传讲。
And in the following conversation, it surprises us of how Jesus responded to Simon and the followers.
那在西门以及这些追随者接下来的对话中，真正让我们惊讶的是耶稣的反应。
He thought that many are looking for Jesus. He might be staying back and to minister them, to respond to their needs.But instead, in verse 38, Jesus said, Let us go to the next town that I may preach there also, for that is why I came out.
我们或许会以为既然这么多人在寻找耶稣，耶稣可能会留下来，然后向这些人传道。但是我们看到第38节的时候，耶稣却说，我们可以往别处去，到邻近的乡村，我也好在那里传道，因为我是为了这事出来的。
In the young people's modern language, they may say, "Adui potong stimo."
如果是用现代的这些年轻人的潮语来说，哇，这真的是有点，就是让人觉得很就高潮迭起，突然间就没有了。
And no, because people are receiving healing, you know, and receive blessings from God. See how Jesus healed them. Suddenly, Jesus say, "One go."
因为就是。大家很兴奋于哇！耶稣看到很多人有神迹奇事，有人得医治，有鬼被鬼附的能够得释放。那突然间，耶稣就说：“哎，我们走吧。”
Then later we may start to doubt God, doubt His love, His kindness.
那可能他就会因此开始怀疑神的这些爱心啊，甚至他的良善。
As we see the verse, did Jesus lose His patience and no longer show kindness to those who are looking for Him?
但是我们看经文的时候，你有看到耶稣就是不耐烦了，然后甚至是没有把这些的没有对这些人施展良善吗
？Definitely no，
肯定没有。
Because in the following text, we still see Jesus not only preaching, but he carried on with his healing to heal the sick and casting out demons.
因为在接下来的经文中，我们可以看到耶稣他不仅是在传道，他还有在医治和赶鬼。
But from Jesus' response, we see Jesus' eagerness and urgency to reach out to many souls as possible.
但是我们可以从耶稣的刚刚那个回答中，当中我们可以看到，就是耶稣他很热切，而且是迫切的，想要尽可能的接触更多的灵魂。
He's not even waiting people to come to him, no. He himself rather carrying the gospel, the good news, to the people around the region of Galilee.
他甚至不是在等待人们来找他，而是要把福音这个好消息传给加利利地周围的不同的人。
Such urgency you can see through the whole gospel.
这样的迫切能够在整个经所有的福音里面都可以看到。
In verse 38, 39, and throughout in the early chapter, verse 4 to verse 15 and 21, in the same chapter 1, we see that there's a repetition on the word preaching, proclaiming, and teaching.
我们可以在整个马可福音第一章里面呢的第38、39节、第4节、4到15节、21节中看到有这个词一直在重复，就是宣扬，就是传讲神的道，还有教导这个词。
Now, such repetition shows that the urgency and also the importance of the message, the word of God.
这样重复的表明呢，就是显示给我们看。 就是这个迫切性，还有它的重要性。
Why is it so important?
为什么这么重要呢？
As Paul said in Romans chapter 10, verse 17, that faith comes from hearing and hearing through the word of Christ.
正如在罗马书十章十七节中，保罗说，可见信是从听到来的，听到是从基督的话来的。
For us to have faith, we first need to hear from the word of Christ.
为了让我们能够有信心的话，首先我们需要从神、从基督听他的话语。And
the teaching of Jesus is authoritative.
而耶稣的教导是有权柄的。Not
of human authority, but from God Himself.
不是来自人的这些权威，而是从神而来的。From
the response of the people on the teaching of Jesus, we see that they were astonished.
我们可以从这些人对于耶稣的教导。 的反应看到，就是他们是觉得很惊讶的。Because
Jesus taught as one who had authority, not as the teachers of the law.
因为耶稣的教导是有权威的，而不是如同文士那般。Because
in those days, the teacher of the law, when they are teaching the law, they often cited the opinions of earlier teachers.
因为根据那个时候的文士，他们在教导的时候呢，关于这些的律法的时候，他们很常是引用先前的教师他们说的这些话。But
Jesus speak for the Father as Himself.
但是耶稣是以自己的身份为天父说话。Because
Jesus Himself is God, and God is the Word.
因为耶稣本身是上帝，上帝就是道。Jesus
is the Word incarnated. To the world, became flesh that dwell among us.
耶稣作为道化成肉身来到世界上。So
the word comes with authority. It shapes us, molds us, and guides us in our daily decision.
因此，神的话语是带有权柄的，能够塑造我们的生命，指导我们做出正确的决定。Maybe
you start feel boring already. Oh.
或许你会开始觉得很闷了。So
many words.
这么多的字眼。Now.
From the urgency and eagerness of Jesus, we can feel it strongly how much He desires us to listen to His word.
但是我们可以从耶稣的这个热切跟迫切当中理解神，耶稣他有多么希望我们能够理解他的话语。Yet
our desire to listen to the word of God is way lesser compared to the eagerness of Christ.
可是我们对于聆听神的话语这样的迫切呢，是比耶稣迫切希望我们听他的话这样的相对起来是。
Sometimes we ourselves may despise His word, thinking that, the word of God is like incompatible with the world, irrelevant with the world.
有时候我们甚至自己会轻视神的话，认为神的话跟我们现在所处的世道好像不怎么相容。And
maybe and Bible, so many words, it's very hard to read.
而且在圣经里面有那么多的字，好难阅读。
And there are times we felt that the sermon sounds unfit to our ears, and we are allowing ourselves to be available, and when we find there are times when we felt that the sermon is unfit to our ears, mm-hmm. then we find ourselves distract ourselves to other things.
那甚至有时候牧师在讲道的时候，我们会觉得这个正道好像不怎么顺耳，那我们就会因此去做其他的事情，被其他东西分心。
We use our gadget, you know, to see other things.
我甚至可能用我们的手机、我们的这些电子器材去看其他的东西。
We are not allowing the word of God to be preached to us.
我们并没有允许神的话对我们说话。
One thing to be sure that the word of God is living and active.
但是有一句有一点可以肯定的是，神的道是活泼的。
It is sharper than any two-edged sword.
是有功效的，比一切两刃的利剑更快。
There are times when people don't dare to speak the truth to us, but the word of God piercing into our soul and spirit, discerning our thoughts and our intention of our hearts.
有时候呢，我们就是有些人可能不敢对我们说真实的话语，但是呢，神的话它会刺透我们的心，让我们能够去分辨真明。
The word of God is profitable.
而神的话语呢，是对我们有益处的。
To rebuke us, to correct us, to train us in righteousness.
以教训读者，使人归正。
So that the word of God can be complete and equipped.
叫属神的人得以完全。
As in the introduction, I've mentioned there are certain things that no one can do for us, but only ourselves.
正如我在引言的时候有说到，就是有些事情其实我们不能够让别人去代替我们做。
It is the same way in our spiritual growth and our relationship with God.
我们的属灵生命的成长以及我们跟耶稣之间的关系也是如此。
We need the first-hand encounter and experience with God, and also our eager to encounter Him.
我们需要亲身的接触、经历神，而且神就是有第一手的这个经验。
As I'm growing, I'm 32 this year.
那我今年32岁。我成长的过程中，
Looking back 20 years ago,
回想二十多年前，
During my youth day, my mom forced me to go to church.
那时候我还是青少年，然后我的母亲会强迫我去教会。
You must go to church.
你一定要去教会。
And it became my routine.
那就变成了一个例行公事。
A habit.
一个习惯。
And as I carry on, no, to go to church.
当我继续去教会的时候呢，
The word of God preached to me.
神的话语对我说话。
The word of God shaped me.
神的话语塑造了我。
Give me a heart that listens to His word.
给我一颗倾听他的道的这个心。
Give me a heart that listens to His Holy Spirit.
然后给我一颗倾听圣灵带领的这颗心。
And from there, no, my habits, my routine becomes my commitment to God.
从而使我原来的这些所谓例行公事或者是一个习惯变成是我对神的一个委身。
It becomes my personal relationship with Jesus.
它变成了是我个人跟耶稣之间的一个关系。
So all of us here,
我相信我们当中的所有人。
If you haven't started to read your Bible,
如果你还没有开始阅读你的圣经，
Start it as in a habit first.
先以习惯来开始
，or a routine，
或者甚至是把它放在你的日程当中的其中一件事情。
Then the Holy Spirit will change it, as in commitment to God.
但是随着时间过去，圣灵会把它变成对神的一个委身。
Keep your heart as a listening heart to God.
让你的心保持成为一颗倾听神的心。
And I listen to God to respond to my calling.
我倾听神的呼召来回应他。
I ask my mom, "Mom, is it okay if I go for full-time ministry?"
我问我的母亲，我说，妈，我可以去全职侍奉吗
？And I'm sorry, maybe in the future I cannot give you a luxury kind of lifestyle.
那我跟他说，非常抱歉，可能以后我没有办法给你一个富裕的生活。
I thank God that my mom also has this listening heart, that he listens to the Holy Spirit.
那我很感谢神的，就是我的母亲，她也有颗倾听神的心，她听从圣灵的感动。
Same to my father.
我的父亲也是。
You must praise your father.
你要赞你的父亲哦。
they answer me with this, no? Seek His righteousness and His kingdom. God will add to our family.
他们这样告诉我, 先求神的国和神的义, 神会加其他的事情加添到我的家庭。
And I give thanks.
我因此献上感恩。
I can listen to the Holy Spirit and I respond.
我可以听从圣灵的感动, 然后回应。
It's through a whole long process.
这一点是经过了很长的一个过程。
From habits,
从习惯,
from routine,
从例行公事,
even by force,
甚至被强迫,
but the Holy Spirit will guide you, change it to your commitment.
但是圣灵会帮助你感动, 把这一切都变成是你对神的一个委身。
Let's respond to the word of God with the song.
让我们用这首歌来回应神的话语。